the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Moore.
Well, it is a chilly start to our weekend across the region. You know, winds last night really died down, and with clear skies, that allowed those temperatures to fall rather quickly. Right now, we're looking live here in Hershey. It's a quiet morning, just some high clouds streaming on through, and temperatures, well, we're cool. 31 degrees in Hershey. It is feeling every bit of that. Winds are calm right now, and, well, humidity 79%. You know, pressure is building just a little bit because we have an area of high pressure that is trying to move its way in, and that's what has been giving us these cool temperatures. Whenever you see these winds relaxing and skies clearing at this time of the year, you have to be thinking about some chilly temperatures. And sure enough, we're waking up with some of these. 27 in Lebanon. That is our cool spot right now. 28 up towards Selins Grove. But a little farther to the west, we're just a couple of degrees warmer around Gettysburg at 34 degrees above the freezing mark. And these temperatures have actually jumped a couple of degrees, a little warmer in the past hour or two. And that's because we have this area of clouds that's moving on in. And just some high clouds, nothing really all that thick. And you can actually see through it. It's almost like a transparent, sort of a translucent, I should say, kind of clouds. And as we go through the rest of today, that's going to lead us to some filtered sunshine as we head into this afternoon. And the Storm Team Forecast, cool and breezy today, highs 52 to 56 degrees. We have Thompson Town, Juniata County in the background here. And, you know, today we'll see those winds kicking up once again, 10 to 20 miles per hour. That was a big weather story yesterday. Once again today, we'll see that. Now tonight, we'll continue to see a little bit of cloudiness around, partly cloudy skies, a little warmer into the mid-30s for those lows. And we will still see the winds overnight, so it will continue to be brisk overnight into tomorrow morning. And tomorrow afternoon, once again, cool and breezy, 10 to 20 mile per hour winds, 52 to 56 for that high temperature. And we'll start off with sunshine in the morning, but those northwest winds kick in, and that's going to bring down some clouds from the Great Lakes. So we will go with scattered clouds during the afternoon. On the almanac yesterday, it was a cool one, 48 for the high, and that is 8 degrees below the average of 56, what we normally see this time of the year. And we did pick up a trace of rainfall with some, you know, very light showers that were trying to make their way down from the northwest around the Great Lakes region. But that wasn't the main weather story. It was the winds. Here are the peak wind gusts from yesterday. And notice several places here are in the 30s, 32 in Coatesville, 31 in Lancaster, and 32 were the highest wind gusts across the Susquehanna Valley. And today, once again, we'll see those winds picking on up as we head through the day. And here's what predictor thinks with those winds, 15, 20 mile per hour winds as we head into this afternoon before they die down a little bit, but still maintain themselves through the overnight hours from the south. But as we go into tomorrow, they're going to shift directions more out of the west, and it'll be a little bit stronger, 10 to 20 miles per hour with gusts around 25 to 30 miles per hour. And then as we go into the day, we'll see those dying down later towards the nighttime hours. Currently on Super Doppler 8, we're seeing the clouds streaming in, a couple of radar returns very far north in the northern part of the state, and they should stay to the north. But again, these clouds are advancing ahead of a cold front that's making its way through. That cold front won't be bringing us any precipitation, but the cloudiness through the day, the southerly winds kick in out ahead of this front here. As we head into tomorrow morning, that front clears on through, northwesterly winds kick in, but starting off with sunshine before the clouds roll into the region during the afternoon hours. High pressure tries to build in here as we go into Monday morning, and it remains rather cool. And then that's when we're watching our next cold front, and that will arrive as we go into late Monday into Tuesday. And you can really see it's kind of moisture starved, but it may be cold enough that we could potentially be seeing a couple of flurries as that front moves on through. But I guess the main factor here will be those temperatures, and we'll watch those going to the next couple of days. Temperatures well below average here all the way into Veterans Day and remaining rather dry, at least until we go Monday night into Tuesday morning, and that's when we'll watch for the chance of precipitation. Again, those temperatures make all the difference, whether we see some raindrops or maybe some snowflakes or maybe kind of in between there. But it is time of the year. Look at those highs, 42 for Wednesday before we warm back up to seasonal levels by the end of next week. But those rumors of the big storm that everyone was talking about, that is not going to be the case this time. Just maybe a couple of flurries at the front.
Got to be careful when people hear that snow word.
Absolutely. Gets a little hypey.
Yes,
that's right.
Yes. All right, Matt. Thanks.